Okay, hi again. This is part two. Previously in part one, I have explained about your profile on Launchpad, how to have a profile, how to edit it, all about your profile, Launchpad teams, Launchpad projects, and a little bit about blueprints. And in this part, I'm going to explain more in details about blueprints. As I said, blueprints play a major role. If you have a team, that team that team have a project to work on. Some teams, they don't have a project. They just kind of organization work on a specific task without any specific project. Or let's be more specific, they don't have a software project to work on. If there's a team and that team has a software project to work on, the best to create a project and the best ever to have a blueprint. So let's explain about blueprints here. Just an example here, the Ubuntu GNOME, the brainstorming area. These are the blueprints related to Ubuntu GNOME. Maybe it's a bit hard because you see so many colors and so many details. I don't want you to be confused. I will go to the blueprint for Tori OS project, which I think it's a bit easier to understand. What I'm going to do is to create a blueprint and then explain on this blueprint, so I don't want to do any changes on these. Let's do that from the beginning. This is Launchpad homepage, but of course you don't need to see that. You need to see your profile. You are part of a project. Now, how to access that project? Let's go with the deep details. I will try to be to explain as someone who just joined Launchpad and he or she knows nothing about Launchpad except he or she knows how to access the profile. Okay, so let's say this is my profile and I want to go to the project and I want to see the blueprints, edit, read, whatever. I scroll down, I go to my latest membership. Basically, I click here to find the project that I would like to go to. Of course, there are many things here, but these are not projects. Please keep that in mind. These are teams, so don't get confused between projects and teams. I have explained that, and I will include the links. I forgot to include that with the first video. No worries. So where is Tori? Okay, Tori, here you go. Okay, so this is Tori team. I don't want the team. I'm already part of the team. How could you how to know you are part of the team or not? Forget about the owner. Of course, you won't be the owner. You will be just a member. So let's go to the active members. Look for your name. Oh, there you go. That's your name. Good. So you are part of this. Okay. Now, how do I go to the project and see the blueprints? I scroll down, go to the related project, click Tori OS. And of course, that the whole whatever I'm doing now, if you don't have the direct link to the blueprints, you need to do this. If you have the direct link, you just voila, you don't need to go to that step one, step two, step three, whatever, you know. So here's the project. Oh, okay, where's the blueprints? Still looking for the blueprints. Oh, there you go, the latest blueprints. Good, we are still in the safe side. So just click here. Okay, now there you go. So again, this is just in case you don't have the direct link. So if someone tell you, "Hey, did you see the latest blueprints for TorOS?" You would be surprised. Or the first question, "How do I go there?" I think now you know how to do that, the old school way or the very basic way. And how to do that, if you have the direct link, you just go click that link and you see the blueprints. Now, how do I register a blueprint? Say, okay, I joined TorOS. TorOS is a project to have a very minimal, very simple system based on Ubuntu, which support the non-PIE machines, the old machines, and give the freedoms to the user to install whatever package he or she likes. Okay, looks interested. How do I be part of this? You need first to join the team. Okay, then view the project, and if that team they ever have any blueprints, you need to go to the blueprints and view that. I think I just explained how to do that. Now, if you would like to contribute, if you want to create a blueprint and make yourself known, make your idea known, or you know, just discuss an idea in your mind that you feel it's going to be helpful for this project. If you ever want to contribute with anything, simply just go to register a blueprint, and we will go through the steps now. Okay, register a new blueprint. Here you need to use lowercase letters only. Just let me check if I'm recording or not. I think I'm live. Okay, good. Just in case. Okay, so let's give it a name. Sample. See if I'm even trying to use caps. I cannot. Sample. Okay, title. Now you can give it a title. By the way, the name here, this one will appear here on this address. That's why it's lowercase. Title. Whatever title you want to do. This is just a test. Okay. Or to make it more professional, just sample. Blueprints. Here, you can include a wiki page. It's just optional. You can add any link. Okay. And here, a summary. This is a sample. Okay, I'm okay. Now, let me explain my way. This is how I do it. I give it a name, I give it a title, write the summary here, and leave these blank. Leave these as they are. Optional. Definition. By default, it's new. There's a list here. Okay, so simply register a blueprint. I'm going to repeat that. When you remember, we clicked on register a blueprint somewhere here. You give it a name, title, summary, and scroll down, register. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Four simple steps. Is it hard? No, I don't think so. Register blueprint. Now your blueprint has been registered. How do I make sure? Go here, the blueprints for Tori, and try to look for yes. That's it. Here's sample. Okay, let's see what we can do with sample. First of all, the address here says sample, which is yours. You just created this one. The title, remember the title. There you go. You can edit it here. See, Launchpad is very flexible, by the way. Change details. If you ever make any mistake here, sample, you can edit that. Okay. Now, how to work on the blueprint. Okay, I'm going to explain the options here and leave the rest for whatever case you have, because it's case to case. Sometimes you don't really need to do that. Sometimes you do need. If you are a project leader or you are someone who is heavily involved, you do need to learn about the blueprint formation and other stuff. I'm going now to talk about this later. I'm going to explain, if you are just a contributor, you don't need to worry about these things like blueprints or formation. You don't need to worry about how to edit that, what does, or yeah, how to edit or how to use it. But you do need to understand, or you do need to know what each of these options means. For example, if you see new, what does that mean? If you see here none, you know, all these things you should be familiar with. If you are just a contributor, you just register a blueprint, someone else now will come to view your blueprint and leave a note. The best way, or actually the only way to do that, is whiteboard. Okay. I have noticed some contributors that they got confused, so they simply click here and edit this one. This is actually not right, because you are updating the body or the summary of the blueprint. This one you should not edit unless you are unless you register that blueprint. Okay. So in my case, I have registered. Maybe I can edit, if I can edit that later, like there's some spelling mistake, or there's some important note I'd like to add, stuff like that. But usually, once you finish the summary here, I don't think you need to go back and edit that unless you have to. The whiteboard, if you want to edit the whiteboard, the best way to do that is click here. Please note that work items go in the separate work items and put field below. Okay. Now, the best way to do this is your name, close that, type your suggestions here, and click this one. Done. Let's go to the blueprints. And there you go. Someone else will come to edit. This is a good idea. You have my, for example, someone else I don't think this is a good idea, so plus one. Now someone else, my friend Phil, my mentor, well, I don't know, so just like that. And there you go. Voila, saved. Now, work items, if this blueprint involves any work item, let's say, by the way, here you can find some help using work items. You can read, it tells you how to deal with this section. Launchpad is very easy, by the way. Okay. For example, you have registered this blueprint, so you're talking about yourself. I have, or you mention your name. Let's say, okay, my name. Then click here. Now, once you do that, your team will be notified. I will explain to you later how. Anyone from your team, anyone who is involved with this project, once he will log into your blueprint, and read the work at him, he or she will understand that you are going to edit the wiki page to reflect the new change, and the status is to do, which means it's on your to-do list and not yet done. Okay. What else do we have? Here we have to do, in progress, done, postponed. So you can use these for status. Once you do that, you update your blueprint with done, and that's it. It's very easy. Sometimes your blueprint, you have, for example, of course, as a project, you won't find just one blueprint. Here, for example, there are so many. Okay. And let me just review one of these, for example. You scroll down, you'll find the dependency tree. What does it mean? It means that the current blueprint that you are viewing right now, which is in red, artwork roadmap for Ubuntu NUM artwork team. In order to achieve this, you do need to first wallpaper contents and artwork trustee Taher. So once these are done, this one should be completed. And this one Ubuntu NUM trustee roadmap depends on the one in red. So this tree will give you the whole picture, the whole will explain everything to you in a very few seconds. You don't really need to read much, just to view that and you'll understand everything. So this is yet another important thing when it comes to the blueprints. Okay, let's go to our sample one. Now, the final part is let's explain the different option that we have here. The approver, let's say approver, let's say okay, you register the blueprint, there's someone else who's going to approve it. If you are the team leader or the driver of this project, then you can just assign this to yourself by pick me. And these not very important unless you have very big projects. If you have a project with very few people, I mean, all of you will work as one team, and this is not really very necessary. But big communities that come into, I've seen they use this one. Assign, this is very important, but there's a catch here. This one can be used if you have a team, and of course you do, because without the blueprints, without the team, there are no blueprints. Without a project, there are no blueprints. You can notify the team whenever any changes, whatever that change is, you can notify your team with an email. So Launchpad send to the mailing list of that team any changes on the blueprint. The catch is, any change, no matter what, will be sent. So you will have so many emails. If that, most cases, is very annoying. So usually you should be careful if you want to assign that to a team or to someone. You can, of course, either to pick me and assign this blueprint to yourself, or remove person, give it to anyone else. For example, if you want to give it to Torios as a team, you can do this, or you can give it to Ubuntu NUM team, for example, and you will see it here. Or you just type the person name, or leave it without, just leave it blank. The priority here is something very important, because from this list you can tell whether this blueprint is important or not. Essential is the highest priority, of course, high, medium, low, undefined, not. Not means, of course, this is not a priority. Direction, approved, needs approval. Definition, approved, pending approval, review, drafting. All these, Okay, and implementation. Okay. So how to use that? Again, if you are a contributor and if you're part of a team, maybe you don't really need to be involved in these things, these settings or these options. But if you are the driver of the team, you, of course, you should learn how to use that. All in all, you need to understand how all this works. Let's go to the now where story. Okay, so now we are on Tori blueprints area. It has 18 blueprints. How if from the first look, how would we tell what the difference between each one? For example, this one is new. Let's see. Torios LTS. The priority is high, so I can understand the priority of this blueprint is high, and the design status of the design is new. Delivery unknown, which means nothing happened. New unknown means nothing happened at all. Assigned Torios, so the whole team will be notified. Series, there is no series here. Okay, let's go to documentation. It's medium. Discussion. Discussion means it's under discussion and the discussion has started already. Delivery unknown and assigned to tutorials. This one, for example, I assign it to myself. This one, discussion but needs infrastructure. This one, discussion, slow progress. Okay. I think, as a con if you are a contributor, you need to pay attention to priority and to delivery. And most important, of course, the priority one, because from this list you can tell which one is important, which one is less important. For example, this one I chose to be an informational, so no real progress here involved, just informational blueprint. Let's go to Ubuntu. Okay, here you can see more. This one is essential. Communication roadmap approved. Okay, delivery good progress and assigned to a sub team here because Ubuntu has, I think, seven. Six major sub teams. So each blueprint assigned to the corresponding sub team. For example, translation assigned to translator, team leader or group leader. The social media moderators assigned to Ubuntu marketing team. Good progress approved, and we don't have any new here. I think we have some completed. As I said in part one, you can go to this list all blueprints. We'll give you everything. See, it's here 21. You can, of course, sort it here by design, delivery, assignee, blueprint name, priority. And from the delivery, you can tell which one is completed. Implemented. Okay. Locked. You can tell which one is completed or not. Now let's go back. Okay, let's go back to your blueprint that you designed and or you registered. And let's say you are a driver or someone very active and very heavily involved with this project, and you would like to participate in this. So, for example, you said hi here. Here. For example, let's say slow progress. Okay, let's avoid this for now. And definition discussion. So if I go back to the main list and scroll down, okay. Now, because it's high, we gave it a priority. So it's high now, it's different. It's discussion. The design phase is in under discussion phase. and the delivery is a slow progress. How do I change that? Let's say after 3 days you have some updates, you can change the whiteboard as I explained how to do that. And sorry, done. And you simply go to this implementation, data available, for example, pending for approval. Then after 5 days, you came back. You can also play with the priority. Of course, perhaps once you have some progress, the priority might be changed, might be higher or lower. It really depends. So let's say after 5 days you are done with this and you want to close it. So if you can approve this, you simply choose approved here, approved, and implementation implemented, status complete. If I change it to slow progress, see started. Again, deployment will not change it actually, implemented will be completed. Or I think blocked will also do the same. Oh no, not blocked, sorry. So yep, implemented, maybe this one, not started. Okay, makes sense. Yep, implemented. And once your blueprint is implemented, it will not be here, you need to go here, and sample is here. Now because it's a sample, I'm going to take it back to its original, not remove person, and none, definition, new, I'll delete everything here, and I will delete everything here. Oh, doesn't allow to do that. Okay, that's good to know. Oh, maybe because it's approved. Let's see now. Let me just refresh it, because I have never done this before. Oh, yep, it's gone. Good. See, now it's gone. So, I hope you got an idea about everything related to the blueprints. It's quite easy. And by the way, if you register a blueprint and you will not assign it to anyone, even to yourself, you still receive email, but you will be the only one who will receive emails. If you assign it to a team, your team, if that team has a mailing list, everyone will be notified. If they don't have a mailing list, they will not be notified. Assigning is just a way to make sure who will work on this blueprint, or just like the bugs, you know, with bugs. If you are familiar with bugs, you'll sometimes find a certain bug assigned to certain developer. So it's a handy way to use. I hope now everything is clear about your profile on Launchpad, team, projects, blueprints, and how to use that. I hope you enjoyed. I hope this one was very helpful for you. And please, if you have any question, just ask. Thank you so much.